Warped Tour. We're out here in Chula Vista, California, just outside San Diego at the Cricket Wireless Amphitheater. Let's go see what's going on today. Who are you excited to see today?
Warped Tour.
It's man.
Sleeping with sirens.
What's your favorite thing about the Warped Tour?
Everything.
Oh, it's a bit reporter. Memphis Mayfire, The Ghost Inside, and Streetlight Manifesto.
What's your favorite thing about the Vans Warped Tour?
That it's all day. Fun. Yeah!
You're excited to see today?
Memphis Mayfire.
Memphis Mayfire, right? And Chunk. Chunk, no Captain Chunk.
What's your favorite thing about Warped Tour?
People. You know?
Free stuff.
Yeah, free stuff. You can't go wrong with free stuff. And I mean, people, a little bit of energy.
Hi, I'm Ryan from Yellowcard here in San Diego at the Vans Warped Tour. This is our first time on the tour in 5 years, and we're just so stoked to be here. We're only 5 or 6 shows in, and it's already just like we've been wanting to do this since last year when we were planning. You know, we asked, basically said, "Hey, Kevin Lyman, can we please be on the Warped Tour next year?" And with good reason, because every show has been amazing, and our fans are definitely coming out in force. It's amazing to see. In 2004, I got to get up on stage with Me First and the Gimme Gimmes and play guitar on a song, and I have like my official Gimme's Hurley Hawaiian shirt that they gave me to wear on the stage. We've gotten to be friends with a lot of those bands that are just legendary to us, Lagwagon and NoFX and No Use for a Name and Pulley and all, you know, I could go on and on, Bad Religion, all those bands through the Warped Tour. That's how we met them, and really sort of got to be, you know, invited into the family. And so the day that Joey Cape came and knocked on my bus and was like, "Hey, dude, come play guitar with us on the song," it was pretty mind-blowing. So that's probably my favorite Warped experience ever. Yeah, we have a new record called Southern Air. It comes out August 14th, the end of the summer. And it's our second full-length record to be released in less than 2 years, which is crazy. But we're super, super stoked about it. We worked really hard on it, and it was a super inspired writing and recording process. We've been making our records with the same producer since Ocean Avenue, so we're almost 10 years in with the same guy producing our albums. I definitely get the vibe that he thinks this is the best record we've ever made, and for someone who's worked that closely with us and is that involved with our songwriting and the production of our records, it's just feels good to know that, you know, 10 years in, not only do you feel kind of like, well, we still got it, but also you're making the best music you've ever made. It's a pretty amazing feeling, so can't wait for it to be out. I mean, we're always going to be Yellowcard. There's always going to be some new flavors. There's always going to be the things that remind you, you know, what it is about our band that you love, and I think we captured all that really well on this record. I will say, I think my favorite thing about this album is how all the songs are very independent of each other. You could listen to each one individually, and it's completely different from the one before and after it. But together, they meld well into a single idea. And similarly, actually, in the way that I think Ocean Avenue, our first sort of big record, did. If you listen to that record, the songs are really different. Every song is and for being so young then, it was crazy that we were able to diversify our writing in that way. And I think we've really returned to that on this record in a way, and not necessarily the exact same sound as that album, but the concept, the idea of having different ideas throughout the album, we did that this time. So it's great though. So far, Pomona is still carrying the torch. I mean, like I said, we're only a week in or so, a week and a half in. So it's hard to say, with the whole tour sort of still ahead of us, which one's going to be the best. But so far, the crowd in Pomona was just, there was something, some kind of magic in the air that day. So we'll see. The rest of the country can hopefully see this interview and know that you have work to do to beat Pomona. So. Well, we tried to put together a set list that covers every single album. A lot of really old school fans are upset because we're not playing something from One for the Kids, but you gotta choose something. You know, it can't all go into a 35 minute set. So, and including playing another new song. Every time we finish a record, we're just like, man, we're gonna be playing Springsteen sets here pretty soon, like 3.5 hours long. So it's great though. We tried to put together a set that really, you know, captures all the albums and gets the singles, but also a couple of songs that are not necessarily just the ones that were out as singles, you know. So, but it's great. We are it's funny. I mean, I hate doing this in interviews talking about how old we are, but so many people, the comment is so like, man, you guys still got it. You have so much energy. It's so amazing. You look like you're 23 still up there, you know. So that feels really good to hear. So it's awesome. We're having a great time.
We're Pierce the Veil, hanging out in our hometown of San Diego right now.
Yeah, baby.
Feeling good, feeling like $1 million, right? How you feeling, baby?
I feel like $1 million bucks.
Good.
I feel terrible.
Tony, I'm sorry you feel terrible.
I feel terrible. No, it's fun. We have a lot of family, friends here, and today should be...
Stress level is at a 10 and a half.
Yeah, a lot of stress going on. But I think after the show's done and we can like actually hang out with our friends and family, then we'll have a good time. We're pumped. Stoked for the show.
This is our third Warped Tour, so definitely not rookies here, right?
Oh, no, not at all. This is our first time on the main stage this year. We're very excited. All the shows have been basically the biggest shows we've ever played in our entire lives. And I'm freaking out.
It's going to be sweet.
But what's your favorite Warped Tour memory?
Ooh, man, there's so many.
We got a lot.
Well, there's one time I was walking back from the barbecue, and I find David from Green Carolina sleeping in the middle of the road where the cars are driving in front of the buses. I basically had to save his life by pulling him back into the bus. Not a smart move to just sleep in the middle of the road, I'll tell you that.
Not a smart move.
So that's your favorite Warped Tour memory?
It just went off the top of my head.
I love
my favorite of this tour is Tino from Mice and Men being locked in our bathroom, and we had to... He fell asleep in there, so we had to take the door apart to get him out.
That was pretty intense. We're putting him on blast.
I saw a girl get launched during our set the other day, and they probably launched her 10 feet high.
Yeah.
And I think she got launched into the barricade pit. And I hope she's okay. I hope you're okay.
I hope you're okay. I hope you're okay. We have a new record coming out on July 16th called...
17th.
Whoa!
Watch your mouth, buddy.
Try that again.
Jumping the gun, I like it.
Whoa!
All right, we got
stress levels in the zone. I'm just thinking 16, 17, 46, 49. 100.
We got a new record coming out. July 17th, new album, Collide with the Sky. Go pick it up. We got a single out right now called King for a Day, featuring our boy Kellen Quinn from Sleeping with Sirens. Yeah.
And we just released
single number two called Bulls in the Bronx. So
check it out.
They're both on iTunes. Go check them out.
Get crazy with it.
Every day, Kellen comes out for a little bit, does a little
cameo,
little duet.
Little sexy cameo.
And every day we try and do a really good job, and then Kellen comes in and just messes everything up.
Man, Kellen.
No, Kellen kills it.
I did wear his hat the other day on stage.
Nice.
A little fedora.
Yeah.
He put it on my overhead mic, please.
Nice.
My plan is on this tour is I'm going to try to run on stage and they're playing and take a picture with Kellen. And I'm going to Instagram it. It's going to be great.
It's called Friendstagramming, right?
Friendstagram. Check it out. Hashtag Friendstagram. It's going to be sick.
I don't think so.